having fancy clothes, having fancy drinks, having fancy food, you know, going to the best restaurant in town. Yes, girls too can invite guys for a date, they think. But personally, if I'll be going on a date, my budget should be around. Hey, what's up guys? You're welcome to my YouTube channel. And I'm your host, Yusuf Tolulaba. And welcome to Just Original. So you are welcome to my YouTube channel. And with me here, I have Michael Ambolo Atife with Ayotunde, and together we're playing fun games, just a series of questions, and we're giving our funny answers to it. And as you can see, I'm not in Lagos, so I left the four corners of my room to Abeokuta. I just came to see my friends and my families, you know, just to have fun. So please stay tuned. See ya. Okay guys, you are welcome back from that very short break, and I hope I've introduced my friends to you now. Yeah, I did. So just like I said earlier, we're playing fun games, and it's just like a question and answer segment. And yeah, so we'll be having some kind of embarrassing but fun questions, and I'll be asking my friends, and they'll be giving their candid opinion concerning it. So I'll be going first in the next slide. See ya guys. Okay, so the first question here is, how much should a date cost? Yes. Well, I know a lot of you must, you know, have a different opinion. My last content was for first date questions, yeah. So now you're asking a question, how much should a date cost? Well, personally, I feel it depends on the guy, or I feel it depends on the person that is instigating the date. Yes, I think I said this on my last content. Yeah. It depends on, depending on the kind of person that is instigating the date. I think a date should be affordable. A date is not all about having fancy clothes, having fancy drinks, having fancy food, you know, going to the best restaurant in town. I don't think all those actually contribute to how a date should be, but in the long run, I feel a date should be affordable. So I might not really give you the price tag, but I think a date should be affordable. You shouldn't break a bank to go on a date with the one you love. So whether it's the lady that is instigating the date, that is, that is paying for everything, or is the guy that is doing it. I know, yes, girls too can invite guys for a date. It's very possible. But personally, if I'll be going on a date, my budget should be around below 10,000 naira. So I think I tried. So, Michael, what do you think?
Well, my name is Michael. They call me Mikboy. I'm going on a date, I think, you know, if it's an indoor game, but let's just say 2-5, you know? That kind of day, you know, low budget date. You don't want to do past yourself now. Guys, check your pocket. But on the norms, going on probably a popcorn date, maybe like 500 naira. You know, this 50 naira popcorn and drink, Coke 150. Sharp guys. Run jukpa, le jukpa, marry, kala, daju, wuwaika. But let's be factual here, you know. Ladies sometimes are too demanding, and you need to try and make an impression of yourself. So, depending on the environment, I think 5,000 should be good, minimum. And max, 7,500. Sharp guy. Yeah, but you know, this shouldn't be all about eating, dressing, going to fancy places. Sometimes just being indoors is enough. Watch movies, catch cruise, talk about some things. So most importantly, it's not all about the money, it's not all about the places, it's more about the moments and the memories, what you get to share. At that point, nothing really matters. It's just having quality time with each other. But dates shouldn't be based on money. Never should. Just on quality time and everything. So, we're good. Ah.
Highest amount on a date, based on my capacity and my account balance and my status, to me, it shouldn't be more than 20,000. I think that's still the highest amount. It shouldn't be more than 20,000 for start.
Ah, so. Most embarrassing moment. Actually, I have two. The day I was remembered on when I stopped bedwetting. And luckily, it was when I brought a girlfriend home. Damn! You know, seeing your past, don't see your present. No, 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 no. That feeling is bad. And the second one, that got caught having sex. Chakalaka chepa che. Damn. Nah, those women are really amazing. But the funniest thing about the sex part was, though she wasn't at home then, so I felt like, oh, home alone, come over. But I didn't get to enjoy the sex. Do you know why? It was when I just decided to go in, like I was just at the tip, just the tip. And I just said, go, go, go. Damn. Next thing was, open book. The girl did not come back. That's the painful part. After that day, I did not see her again. If you are watching this, I'm looking for you. Come, let's finish that mission.
The most embarrassing moment with my date, bro, is being caught by my mom. The woman, I can't say she's a thug concerned to my matter. She's a thug and she's everything to me. The most embarrassing moment is being caught at home and I was seriously beaten. Not with just ordinary weapon, but with the nearest weapon, which was our office shoe. I just don't want to bring up things like it was very brutal and I was very embarrassed because the way I was beaten then in front of the girl, it was very, very, very embarrassing and I don't think such can happen again.
Okay, my most embarrassing moment. This is how it all happened. I might take your time, but I think every time I take is worth it. So please just find the popcorn and a bottle of drink and enjoy this. Okay, I think the most embarrassing moment I actually had with my parents was just actually my dad, yeah, with my dad. He was the one that took the matter up seriously. And that was the day he saw text message for my then girlfriend on my phone, and this was the way it all happened. So I will narrate it so that people will know that I did not lose guard. But you know, when God wants to reveal you now, nothing that you can always do, your eyes will always open. So as I then, I was using a very small phone, that's this small Tecmo phone, as my second phone, and my dad was actually using the same phone as at that time. So I was ironing on the ironing table, and my dad and my other siblings and my mom were at the sitting room, which was not far from each other. And the whole thing that happened was, the phone rang, like a message came in, and my dad actually thought it was his phone. You know, I said earlier that we use the same model of phone, the same color and everything. So my dad thought it was his phone, and there was no password on the phone. So he just took up the phone, and just opened the message, and I read it, and he just smiled. I knew, because I was expecting the message at that time, and I knew it was my phone. So while I was ironing my clothes, I knew I was in deep shit. Like, really, really deep shit.
Me planning my funeral already.
Early morning, I got this, just, what did I even do, self? It was like, just a very small mistake then. And it's like, started talking, started shouting, you have a girlfriend, this and that. I was, God, I was so embarrassed because he shouted, and I know probably then our neighbors will definitely hear of it. And even up to now, anytime I remember that, like, it's always bugs me, like, God, what have I got myself into? But I think I'm above that. And if I'm to pick the top one most embarrassing moment with my parents, yeah, so it has to be it. So. Holy Father, screaming, my lady.